Hi, I'm Rob Dana, and today I'm going to show you how to set the valve lash on a hydraulic camshaft on the lifters and valves. I bought a comp cam thumper cam for this small block Chevy 400, and I know a lot of you out there don't know how to set the valves, and this ought to take the mystery out of it. So I'm going to show you what we got to do. You can see the push rods right here and the rocker arms. Right now I have them all set, but I'm going to back them off just on one cylinder to show you how to adjust those. So right now we need to set the motor to where one of the exhaust or the intakes is going down. So we rotate the motor until it does that. Okay, you can see this valve right here, the lifter's starting to come up and get it started right there. Okay, now you can set the valve lash on the opposite valve. Okay, if you look right here, you can see that the intake valve is pushed up, and that's a good thing, because now we're going to adjust the exhaust valve. So what you do, I'm going to adjust this valve since the other one's pushed up. It's pushed down. So tighten it right to where it snugs up. Let me back it off again. Sometimes if you're not sure, you back it up till it's really loose. Rotate nice and easy. And just come down on it real slow until you feel the resistance. Right there. Once you feel the resistance, you stop and give it a half turn. Okay, and that's that. Now we're going to rotate the engine so the other valve starts pushing down, and we'll adjust this valve or this rocker. Okay, now you can see that I've rotated the engine and this lifter is pushed up. That would be your exhaust valve. So that's just going down. So keep it where it's going down. Okay, we're gonna back this off half a turn. That's where I had it adjusted. So you can spin it nice and easy with your fingers. Now we're gonna tighten it until you feel it get tight. There's tight. And then we're going to give it a half a turn, like that. Okay, now this cylinder is set. And you follow that procedure one cylinder at a time. That's how I do it. Some people, you know, you set the can or the crank at a certain position. I don't do that. I just make sure I do one cylinder at a time. And you won't have any problems if you do it like that. And then you'll be ready to fire it up as soon as you get it all back together. One other thing that you need to be a little bit cautious of when you're setting these is there's not been oil pressure on the lifters, and so they will push down. So, okay, after I've adjusted that valve, you should be able to push the push rod and the rocker down towards the lifter. That means the lifter is not pumped up yet. So you want to make sure when you're adjusting these that after you've set it, you make sure that the lifter pumps like that, because it's real critical that you don't over tighten it. So just make sure you got movement after you adjust it. Some people will turn the nut all the way down and bottom it out, and that's not good. So make sure you've got this movement in the lifter when you've finish setting the valve on each one. All right. and that should be it.